In this video, I will show you how easy it is to use Power BI to connect to your data. Keep watching. Let's start by taking a look at the Power BI desktop interface. At the top is a ribbon, and I love that because I've certainly grown familiar with it over the years using it with Office. So a lot of functionality is exposed very conveniently through the ribbon, and we're going to explore and dig into each of these tabs. For now, just know that it's there. On the left, you have three tabs. They're not going to look very interesting right now. Three tabs with three views. The first is a report view, the next one is a data view, and the last one is a relationship view. And on here are visualization and fields. Again, we're going to bring in some data, and as we go through it, you will see all of these elements in action again. So really, that is the first step you do in Power BI Desktop, which is you get data. Now, if you look here, if you click Get Data, it lists some of the common sources. But if you click More, you got access to every little thing. And the Power BI team is constantly adding connectors to new data sources. Often, even if a connector is not available, you can sometimes connect to it using a genetic driver, like an ODBC driver, perhaps. For our scenario, we're going to start off by connecting to an Access database. And what I've done is I have saved my files in C:\temp. So this is the database that I'm first going to connect to. And in our scenario, this is representing some system data source, right? So typically in any organization, a business user would connect to some system data source. It could be a data warehouse, SQL, SAP, something like that. In our case, we're just going to have an Access database, which stands in for that. So I'm going to hit connect. And if I go to C:\temp, that's my AdventureWorks database. I'm just going to click open. And for a lot of these connectors, the first steps are going to be different, how it connects to, how it authenticates to it. But from that point on, often the navigation experience is the same. So a lot of data sources you connect to, it'll just show you the list of entities that it found. In this case, it's showing me the list of tables that it found inside that Access database. Now I can click on each one and it generates a quick preview. In case there are lots and lots of tables in the system database perhaps that you're connecting with, then you can use the preview to make sure you're pulling in the right data table. In our case, I'm just going to select each one of these. And for now, you notice down at the bottom there are three buttons, load, edit, and cancel. For now, we're just going to click load, and that's going to load it in the database. So now it's actually going to the data source and copying that data set into my Power BI desktop file. So let's go ahead and save this file first. So C:\temp. All right, and we'll say Power BI. Now what I wanted to do was to show you what that file looks like. So let's go to details. And if you can zoom in here. So notice this was my Access database. It's about 20 megabytes in size. And this is my Power BI model. Now it's just about less than 4 megabytes in size. Now this is interesting because we pulled in every single table from that Access database. And you can see that our Power BI model is noticeably smaller. So that's one advantage of having a data model, that the underlying technology. So one of the techniques it's using for compression is called columnar compression. So instead of storing data row by row, it's storing it column by column. And that gives you a very good compression ratio. It also has other optimization techniques which it uses to compress data. So right, so we pulled in this data set, and that data set is copied over and saved in this file. Now, if we were to connect to 5 different data sources, each one of those will be pulled in our file and a copy would be kept within the file. And the only time it'll go back to that source would be when I hit refresh here, or we'll talk about how you can set up automatic refresh using the PowerBI.com service or other capabilities, right? So when the refresh is invoked, either manually or through an automated process, that's when the model connects back to the source and gets the data. So all the tables have been pulled in here, and now this looks a little more interesting. Now we have fields on the side. We see these tables over here. And if I go to the data tab, this looks alive. Again, we have the tables, and I can tab through different tables, look at customer, look at product, see what's going on, just sample the data I have pulled in. Look at the relationship view, and it does create some relationships automatically. We'll talk a lot more about relationships and tables later, but for now, let's just focus on getting data. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.